Well, it seems like we're back home here in Genoa, as the Genoa Comets are going to be playing host to the Oak Harbor Rockets here in Toledo Sports Network coverage of high school football. Hi, folks. Mick Gonzalez here, along as always, by the man, the legend, Mr. Mike Jamison. J-Mo, this one is going to be an interesting one, because usually there's always a big buildup to this one. Genoa is a team that's looking to rebound and build back up. They had the tough loss last week against Archbold. Now they've got to come in and face an Oak Harbor team that, well, they spanked Fostoria last week 55-7.
And something you're going to see with Oak Harbor too, folks, is the fact there are a lot of young guys on this team that are just incredible athletes, and they can move the ball all over the field, fast pace, where Genoa is bring it right up the middle, you know, typical Northern Buckeye football, where they push it and they push it and they try to get the run in. So I think what you're going to see here is maybe an offensive battle where, you know, a big, big number game, or you're going to see both of these teams really kind of put the erector set together for defense.
Yeah, well, I think the thing, too, is you got to realize you've got a first-year coach for Genoa. You've got a guy with 15 years at the helm for Oak Harbor. You've got a lot of differences here, but I think at the end of the day, I would think that the game's going to be decided in the trenches.
I got to agree. I think it's a heart game. This is that game, Oak Harbor, Genoa. Oak Harbor's going to be coming into the Northern Buckeye, and a lot of big things are happening, and it's bragging rights. We actually got them this week, and Oak Harbor will be taking on Rossford next week. So we're going to be seeing a lot of Oak Harbor this year, and I'm just looking forward to a really good game.
Yeah, same here. You know, they want to finish off strong in the Sandusky Bay Conference, the Bay Division. Well, Oak Harbor and Genoa getting ready to hook it up, and we'll have the kickoff when we come back. It's high school football. That means it's the Toledo Sports Network. Week two of the high school football season getting ready to kick off here as the Genoa Comets and Oak Harbor Rockets get set to tangle here in future NBC action. right now it's the NBC versus the SBC. But to be fair, this, even though it's a non-conference game, these two teams have hooked it up many a time over the years consistently, usually in the first or second game of the season, and it has always been a very fierce tussle.
Well, I think that's what you're going to see tonight. You know, we talked a little bit about it, Mickles. This is definitely going to be a hard-fought battle, and, you know, a lot of big things are going to be happening tonight, and hopefully if you're a Genoa Comets fan, you're going to see something that you like.
Well, Fulton Krupp getting ready to kick things off here for the Oak Harbor Rockets. Of course, you've got Robert Messenger and company getting ready to receive it. It'll be grabbed at the 11-yard line, coming back up around here, and great coverage by the Rockets as Messenger only gets it out to about the 14-yard line, and that's where the Comets will scrimmage to open this ball game first and 10.
Well, something we're going to see a lot of tonight, I think we're going to see it early, is, you know, running guts right up the front, and, you know, Coach Vickers is there now working on those guys. You know, you never know what you're going to see.
Yeah, that's true. Mike Vickers coming back as the offensive coordinator here for the Comets under first-year coach Bill Fisher. And it's going to be interesting to see what kind of offense they have here for the Genoa Comets. Aiden Brunkhorst is going to be quarterbacking here for the Comets as he's got twins on each. He's got twins on each side and empty backfield. Brunkhorst is going to pull it down and run it himself. He's going to get it maybe to the line of scrimmage, and that's about it. Gavin Bulliard is on the stop there. So it'll be second and 10 here for the Comets. You're going to be playing right into the sun.
I'm in the van, and it's still sunny.
Yeah, so this is going to be interesting to see how it affects plays. Runcorse rolls out to his left, pulls it down, and again brought down for no gain. They're seeing how where they spot it. But that's the one thing about Oak Harbor. They are very quick on that line. And, of course, they had a lot of guys out there that can play. I mean, you look at – we talked about Bolyard, but don't forget they've got Caleb Wood, Dominic Wolf, guys like that that can get the job done. And it's going to be interesting to see what kind of plays the Comets are going to have to combat this defensive line rush.
I think you're right, Mick. I think you're right. It's definitely going to be – there's that pass, too.
Out to the left side. That pass is complete. Close to a first down, or down rather. Drummond with the reception. So Mason Drummond, he is the leader of this receiving core. And, of course, that moves the sticks. And a big first down here for Genoa early in this ballgame.
You know, just backside perfect right there, Mick. And that's what they wanted to see. Nice job.
First and 10. Aired out over here on the left side. A little too high. As they had the right idea, but unfortunately it was a little too high for Austin Teat, who is a 6'3", 165-pound junior. That'll make it second and 10.
I'd like to say thanks to all our great sponsors. Of course, Genoa Bank. And haven't seen Marty yet, but I'm sure I will. And looking forward to saying hi to the old fella.
Twins on each side here on second and 10. The ball at the 25-yard line. Thrown over here on the left side. Wheel out. And that one is completed. Aiden Mantry is the guy that brought carried the ball. And it's going to be a pickup of about 5. So it'll be 3rd and 5 here as the clock continues to roll. 10:09 to go.
I'm with you, buddy. I just have a few little, dilemmas.
That's okay. Here, a quick dart over the right side. That pass is complete. That should be enough for a first.
No, I think
he did drop it.
Yeah, he did.
Yep.
He did.
Gantry dropped it, so it's going to be a fourth down. And the Comets will have to punt. Again, that delightful glare of the sun playing havoc with the Toledo Sports Network.
Well, you know, I was kind of thinking we were going to see a little bit more running guts on that first round there. And but good stuff, though.
That's okay. Here's the kick. That one off the end of the foot. That one is not a good kick. It'll go. Will it make it? Let's see where they spot the ball. There's a. Where in the world are they spotting this?
Oh, my goodness.
I think there's a flag on the play.
I see the flag. Yep. Flag's down.
I mean, they gave – that son must have played havoc with that official because he missed that one by easily 10 yards. And I'm not saying that he's a bad official. I'm just saying with that son in the eyes, that definitely made a difference. So the Comets get a huge break here as they're going to spot that ball. First and 10 at the Oak Harbor 33-yard line. In the shotgun. Our first chance. Now here's a handoff going around the left side, but nothing doing. That Ooh. Comet defense rising to the occasion.
Well, that's what you wanted to see, right? That's what you wanted to see out of Genoa. The defense. Defense have always been a big responder here at Genoa.
Donnie Tucholsky was the main man on that play as he shut the door. And they lost 5 yards. So it's going to be 2nd and 15 here for. Well, let's see what we got here. I think I had said it was at the 33 originally. It was at the 37, and I apologize, or 38. I apologize for that. So now with the 5 yard loss, it is at the 33. Here's the pass on the left side, complete. Pickup of about 7, maybe 8. So Aiden Burrow, the receiver on that one off that pass from Lalonde, and it's going to be 3rd down, and we're looking at about 6, maybe 7.
They need to get it to the 48-yard line. And the ball is at the 43, so we'll see what happens here. Third down here for the Rockets. Lalonde drops back, pulls it down. He's going to run. He's going to get dropped, though. Big-time sack. How about Braylon Bryant, that 5'9", 163-pound senior?
Right, let's watch that one, because I'll tell you what, that was incredible. Nice stuff.
Pure speed right there from Bryant, and it makes it fourth down for the Rockets. So, kicking situation here for the Rockets is Zach Kuhn will do the honors. He gets it up a high kick, but not very deep. And it's going to be falling down to make the catch at the 34-yard line. Well, let's see here. It'll be first and 10 for the Comets as they'll take it at their own 34-yard line. Here with 7:44 left in quarter number one. We are scoreless, each team now having had a possession. And, well, the defenses are here to play this ball game. They're taking it serious.
I think what you're seeing here, Mick, is, you know, these young guys want to get into a position and make things happen. And, boy, they're definitely doing it.
Okay, here's Messenger going around the right side. He's got a couple blocks. Able to pick up 5, maybe 6 yards. He'll be dropped near the 40-yard line, maybe the 41.
I like that.
So Burrow in on the stop. We're going to hear his name called a lot here tonight.
Nice, nice run. Nice run.
Pickup of 7 yards here for the Comet back. That makes it second and 3. Ball at the 41-yard line. Here's the fake handoff. Ed Brunkhorst keeping it. He's going to pick up the first down and more as he's able to fight his way into Rocket territory, and he'll be brought down at the Oak Harbor 48-yard line.
Now we're going to watch that one again, Mick, because I'll tell you what, this is just perfection for the offensive line. Look at the blocking. Incredible blocking there, and they were able to get in what they needed to get in, got the first down.
Huge, huge pickup there for the Comets. A little tentative in that first possession that they had, but now that their defense really gave them some confidence, they're now starting to move that football.
Totally, totally agree with you there, brother.
First and 10 from the Oak Harbor 48. Ooh. Antry carrying the ball up the gut. He'll pick up several yards. He'll pick up about 5, maybe 4 or 5 at the 44, so we'll give him 4 yards. So it'll be second and 6 here. Long shadows now starting to draw over the field. You can see it there from our cameramen. You've got Dave up on high camera. Low camera is Rick.
But I wish it would just stay like this, you know. I love this time of the year.
Yep. Here's Brunkhorst, drives up the gut, but this time the door is closed. He is dropped there. Zach Kuhn in on the stop. He was there along with Caleb Wood, who we mentioned. He's one of the smaller guys at 5'10", 290. So here we go, big third down. Loss of a yard, so it's 3rd and 5. Brunkhorst fires it to the left side, too hard, too hot for Messenger.
And that, you know, that's the problem too. You know, getting the timing, Mick, with these guys with the receivers, it makes it tough for them.
Couldn't agree more, buddy. So it's going to be fourth down here for the Comets. This is one of those where do you go for it or do you try to just pin them deep? And it looks like they're going to try and pin them deep in their own end. Messenger was on the sideline fixing his helmet, and that, of course, he's also their punter. Now, that's not a bad thing, but the problem is that the time clock, well, they're able to get the snap off in time, and That one was almost blocked, but Messenger able to get it away. It takes a Genoa bounce, but it goes sideways out of bounds, and it'll be first and 10 here for the Oak Harbor Rockets as we've got 5:12 to go here in quarter number one as we are scoreless here in Genoa.
Big thanks going out to Maumee Bay Turf. Brad Morrison helping us out all the time. Tas Electronics has been with us in making things happen like they always do. Thank you, Al, and all the great people over there. Of course, Scott Winkowski, attorney at law, who has been nothing but great to us here. Genoa Custom Interiors, great, great folks. I'm going to have them do some carpeting work for me here, Mick, in the house. And, you know, my Berber carpeting that's as old as your toupee.
I didn't know I wore a toupee, but okay, hey.
And, of course, Genoa Jewlers and Graymont all helping us bring you Genoa football, and we do appreciate them more than you could ever imagine. So thank you. And not to mention Taylor Automotive Group with our unsung hero that we'll be talking about today. And, Mick, we got to keep an eye out for that unsung hero.
Yep, that we do. And it's not always going to be the guy who has the most yards or the most TDs or most receptions, et cetera. It's the guy who is just the guy who helps and is in there plugging away. Most people wouldn't necessarily notice him.
Oh, is there a flag there? They bring it back?
Yeah. Well, I think they did bring it back.
It's kind of weird.
So it'll be Jackie Hayward in at quarterback here for Oak Harbor. Hayward had a big game. He had a big game. So last week, in their game against Fostoria, he'll keep it. He'll run with it. He is a track star by trade, so he was able to carry that ball quickly and pick up a fast five. And, of course, last week, Hayward was a stud. He was able to run. I'm trying to remember. I believe he ran and picked up a couple of touchdowns. Just a really exceptional athlete. So we look forward to seeing what dynamic he brings here to this game against Genoa.
Good kid, too.
Second down.
Here it's coming this way, too.
Oh, got a penalty on the play. The entire press box lit up when they saw the hold. So it's going to be coming back here, and Oak Harbor is going to have to come back into the shadows of their own end zone.
Mickey, I got this one. If they're gonna give us time here, I'm gonna run this one for you here.
Oh
this
yeah,
is, this is, yeah, this is quite the hold right there.
So they'll mark it back to. Looks like around the 6 yard line they're gonna spot it. And the first "you can't do that" chant from the student section of the season.
We talking? What are we talking? Second and 11.
Second and 12, it looks like.
All right. I put second and 11, so we'll just go with that.
We'll work with it. Second down here for the Rockets. So the ball is being carried there by Hayden Burrow. And Burrow, he is dropped there. So he is dropped there. I'm looking to see who's dropped there by Andrew Sapila, who you know very well. At least
Sapilia.
His dad, anyway. You say Sapilia, but it's Sapila.
Sapila. It's not his dad. It's his uncle.
Okay. Well, I'm just saying it's Sapila because there's no IA on the end. You and I have gone toe-to-toe over this over many games here on TSNW TV.
Sure.
And we'll continue to do so because it's great fodder. Oh, it's flushed out of the pocket. It's going to be a run. And getting away is Hayward using those track skills to his advantage. And he is going to take this one all the way. As long as there's no flags, and I don't see any, he's going to take it to the house. Wow. Unbelievable. A 91-yard touchdown run to get Oak Harbor on the board as they lead it now 6-0 with a point after still to come.
Wow. Mick. I mean, wow. That, you know, he just broke away. And, of course, we broke our instant replay computer all at the same time. So I didn't. Right when he ran, it died on me here.
It outran the replay computer.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah.
But a 91-yard touchdown run. Number 36. Jackie Hayward, wow. Mighty impressive. So they're going to attempt the point after here. Krupp puts the ball up, and it is no good. So with 3:21 to go, the point after is missed, and Oak Harbor leads this one by a score of 6-0.
Fans, it's tailgate season. Everyone is welcome and encouraged to come out and support Comet football.
From the kitchens of Italy to you, Arturo's Pizza Kitchen is the home of authentic Italian food. As one of the oldest independently owned pizzerias in Toledo, Arturo's Pizza Kitchen has been serving since 1988. With pizza, salads, award-winning subs, chicken chunks and wings, mom's own lasagna recipe, and our famous cheese sticks, we have it all. Never frozen, always homemade. Arturo's Pizza Kitchen. Hungry? Call Arturo's, 419-698-1641.
Stop struggling with the big box stores. Choose Gladio.
A hardware store, yet so much more. Your home improvement answer store. A place to design your interior space. A professional and friendly smiling face. Everything you need for your home. And Gladio is locally owned. You'll be glad to know.
Fulton Krupp going to kick off here for the Rockets, as right now they enjoy a 6-0 lead over the Genoa Comets. Messenger will pick it up at the 18-yard line. Gets over the 20, the 25, going outside. Gets brought down at about the 29-yard line, and that's where the Comets will scrimmage first and 10. You know, what made that run so incredible was the fact that it looked like he was going to – there was just a pile up there in the front line, and it looked like he was going to be brought down. But he just spun and accelerated to a whole nother level.
I totally agree. And he found right where he needed to be, and, man, he just exploded.
He just put it in another gear. Empty backfield. Brunkhorst looks downfield. He's going to fire it over on the right side. Oh, threw it in between receivers. He had two receivers right there near midfield and basically split the difference, and it dropped in between them incomplete.
Something I think we're not used to seeing is this passing game that Genoa's doing right now. Do you notice that?
Yeah, well, Bill Fisher, him and, I mean, he's a first-year coach here. So, but he has been an assistant for a number of years, and now Brunkhorst is going to get drilled from behind and brought down for a loss of about maybe 10. As Radner brings him down, it'll be third and a cab ride. It looks like about third and 20. And they'll spot that ball at about the 19. He needs to get it out to the 39.
We'll bring up third and 20.
Clock continues to run here as we come up here on 2:40 to go in the opening quarter. Twins on each side once again here for Aiden Brunkhorst. He'll take the snap, drop back, fires it over the left side. It's complete.
Nice.
They get it, a pickup of about 10 yards, but they needed 20, so the pass was complete to Austin Teat. So that'll make it fourth down.
Gain of 10 on the play, and bring up fourth and 10. Stop is made by number 15, Jacob Reiter.
I'm just wondering if Oak Harbor knows that with Messenger being the punter, if they might not necessarily feature him in third down plays.
You could be right, Nick.
Low snap. Ooh, Messenger took a while there, but he got the kickoff. It's grabbed at the 40-yard line. Hayward darts outside, changes direction, and he's off again. But this time he's going to run out of real estate as he will go out of bounds, but in Genoa territory, as they'll spot that ball at approximately the 36-yard line.
I mean, we get this one on instant replay here out of the punt. He's just so good at being able to move left and right, and it's just incredible watching what he's able to do with that. Just, wow, great, great stuff right there.
Well, you know, I mean, last year he was a dual threat. He completed 79 of 153 last year, for 748 yards, 10 touchdowns. But he also rushed 102 times for over 660 yards.
Oh,
here's
wow.
a handoff. This time around, the Genoa front line there closed the door on things.
Stop made by number 52, Donkowski.
You can always tell when it's not Hayward running, but this time around, they were with the in the steady hands of Hayden Burrow. But Tucholsky said, nope.
Mick, give me that downage again.
Well, it's going to be second down and 9 after the pickup of 1. That ball is spotted. They're spotting it at the 35.
Gotcha. Thank you, sir. See, people don't realize I'm in the truck tonight, so.
It's all right. Here's a swing pass on the left side to Burrow. Burrow's driving forward.
Another flag.
Flag comes down, but we'll see what happens. Here's Lalonde was the quarterback, Michael Lalonde, as he tosses that one to Burrow. Burrow carries or takes the mail, and, well, they're going to see if that one comes back or not. And it looks like it's going to come back. Holding on Oak Harbor.
Holding against the Rockets.
So they'll move the ball back. Well, it's a spot foul, so they'll move it all the way back to about the 41.5 yard line. Just outside the 41. So second down and about, we'll call it maybe 14. Ooh.
Well, not good numbers there. You know, we've seen a lot of penalties already so far tonight. And
That's two, maybe three penalties. Is timeout taken here with 32 seconds by Oak Harbor. So it's still 6-0 Oak Harbor as we are late in the first quarter.
Graymont and Genoa, producers of dochlamide, lime, and hydrate, serving the community for over 90 years. The plant currently has 60 employees. The safety and development of these employees is a focus for your plant. Over 80% of our employees currently live within 11 miles of the plant. Graymont. For more information about this company, you can check us out on the web at www.graymont.com.
Thank you to our military members and first responders. We look forward to seeing you at the game next week.
Well, it's nice having all these cameras and being able to see all these kids working so hard out here for both of these teams. And it's just such an incredible amount of, I can't even say it, when you look back at all the years with these games.
Hey, we're now airing it out deep on the left side, and it falls incomplete. It was intended for Jackson Overmeyer. There's a couple of Overmeyers here. There's Jackson and Judson. And that was for Jackson, but he was covered by Robert Messenger, who was working both ways. So third and 15, they're going to call it. Yep. I think I said 14 because they were just outside the 40.
Screwed up, Beck. Just face it.
Yeah, true.
We do it every Saturday morning from 8 to 10.
And Sunday mornings from 9 to 10.
There you go. No, you do that by yourself.
Yeah, I screw up by myself royally on Sunday.
Yep.
Sure, Chris Fargo appreciates that. My
co-host. He's a good dude, man.
Yeah, he is. Here we go. Burrow goes up the gut, and he is not able to get much, so it will be fourth down. Now, they're inside the 40 here, Coach Jameson. Do you go for it?
I think if you're Oak Harbor, yes.
They're not going to kick a field goal here. They don't have the leg. They got a freshman kicking.
Right.
And now, granted, he's a soccer player, so he can kick along, you know, a decent distance. But at the high school level here in the NBC, you're not going to see a kid kick one 57 yards.
Right, right.
Timeout on the field here.
No, that's a quarter.
That's because it's the end of the first quarter. I was going to.
Oh.
Can I finish my thought?
Sorry.
Thanks, Dad. Anyhow, we've got one quarter in the books here at Genoa High School as it is 6-0 Oak Harbor over the Comets. This is the Toledo Sports Network here on CW 13.
Genoa Jewelers, 611 Main Street in Genoa, has been serving the area with quality jewelry and gifts for over 19 years. Specializing in gold and silver repairs, Frank Homais has been a goldsmith for over 30 years. Our selection of Pulsar watches, Precious Moments figurines, Reflections beads, Seraphim classics, and quality Stellar rings, all at a price you can afford. Genoa Jewelers also buys gold and silver and has the perfect gift for that someone special. Stop out today at Genoa Jewelers, 611 Main Street in Genoa.
Fourth down. Punting situation here for the Rockets.
Easy on that camera.
And they look like they were going to fake it, but they decide to punt it. Messenger is going to let it go. It takes a bounce. And I believe it went into the end zone. So it will be first and 10 here for the Comets. And they will scrimmage from their own 20-yard line.
Hey, Rick Lalonde, who is actually going to be working with you next week at Oak Harbor. Oak Harbor is going to be playing Rosford at Oak Harbor, and we'll be over there doing that game, looking forward to that one. Right now, they're up 14-0 on Port Clinton. Rosford's losing 14-0 right now, Mick.
Okay, yep, as they are facing the Indians, and now they'll head to Oak Harbor to play the Rockets next week. Also, a shout-out to Patrick Andrus here from the Blade covering tonight's game. He's brand new to the Toledo Blade, as this one is passed over on the left side, nearly intercepted, but it falls incomplete.
I'm going to look at that one again, because I'll tell you what, that just didn't look right. You know, I'll tell you what.
Yeah.
Oh, a little horse collar kind of thing there. I don't know, Mickles.
Well, it's like I said, it's early in the season. The officials they're working out their things too. So it's second and 10. Again, an empty backfield here for Brunkhorst. He's going to throw it over the middle. It's complete.
Nice.
And now it's, one man to beat. That was so close. As Austin Teat went over the middle, and if he could have just gotten by that last tackler, he was off to the races.
Well, if you've noticed so far tonight, Mick, it seems to be the off-speed stuff. It seems to be – now they're in a hurry-up offense here too. They're doing everything, kind of mishmashing it, and I really like it because so far I'm impressed.
Very much so. Here's a handoff as it's going up the gut once again, this time – it is Aiden Antry. Antry able to pick up a good chunk of real estate as he picks up, I believe, looks like 8 yards. So they'll spot the ball at the 43-yard line of Genoa. Second and we'll call it a short two or a long one, whichever you prefer. Just inside. They need to get just inside the 45-yard line.
Gotcha. And just as I said that, Rosford scored. 14-7.
There you go. Here's the handoff. Up the gut they go. This will be enough for a first down.
Antry
able to dive forward. They'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line. So it'll be first and 10 for Genoa as they move the sticks.
We do appreciate all the great people that put up with us. Gosh, now it's 3 days a week, Mick. Isn't that scary?
It's frightening, but
yeah,
it's what we do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and again, I got to tip my hat to the wonderful folks. It's been a between the pandemic and everything else, it's been a while since I've been here in Genoa. And now going around the outside is Messenger as he's going to move the sticks. Well, no, they're going to spot him about a yard and a half short. Burrow brings him down, but not till Messenger gets it out inside to the 45-yard line of Oak Harbor. So second and short.
There's what we wanted. Nice job, guys.
So Genoa doing a better job this series of moving that football as they're not facing the sun.
That's always a good thing, isn't it?
Yeah, it makes it a little tougher if you're on the defensive side of the ball here.
I've been here so many times when it was snowing, so, you know, I'm not complaining tonight.
So Antri picks up the first down. He'll be brought down at the 41-yard line of the Rockets. That's what we hope for. So thoughts and prayers definitely for Mr. Judson Overmeyer. Meanwhile, with the clock starting up again, 9.5 to go. Here's the handoff on first and 10. Messenger takes it over the 40, inside the 40 to the 39. As he was brought down by Mr. Burrow. Burrow a dual threat on each side of the ball. So it's going to make second and about 8.
Thank you, sir. I remember the days when you and I used to do it right, do the whole football game right here.
Yep. And yes. During the pandemic, we just sat in the production truck. That always made for some interesting times.
Yeah, we don't want to do that anymore, especially after you've eaten at Burrito City, you know.
Stop it. Here's the handoff as they go up the gut again. Antri gets it to the 37. And so that'll make for third and manageable. So he was brought down there by Brooks that brought him down. So that'll make third down. We'll call it third and 6 at the 37. Empty backfield once again here for Brunkhorst. He'll take the snap. He'll throw it out over on the left side. A little too much air on that one.
Well, you saw it again when the receiver went over. He kind of double-stepped when he got at the end of his route there. So the timing's still not right there, Mick, and that makes it tough to be able to get those timing patterns down and get that ball out there where they need it.
Well, it's going to make it fourth down. And, again, this is a little too far out of field goal range, so they're most likely going to go for it, and that they will. Twins on each side. Brunkhorst by himself in the backfield here in the shotgun. They need to get it to the 31-yard line of Oak Harbor. Here's the snap. We got the rush flushed. Throws it over the middle. It's
nice.
Complete. Now it's a question of getting to that first down marker, and they do. Great effort there. Individual effort from Mason Drummond. Drummond was coming across, able to grab that ball, and then he had to fight for every inch he got, but he was able to get it down to the 30-yard line, and that'll move the sticks.
Yeah, watch this. Just really good how he splits out and gets to the middle at the wide-open spot there, and then he fights for that first down.
First and 10, Comets at the Oak Harbor 30. Here's the handoff. Messenger cuts inside. He's going to follow some blocks, able to push forward and get inside the 25-yard line. Or let's see where they spot that ball. Looks like at the 24. So a nice pickup of 6 for Messenger. He was brought down there by, looks like Hoyer brought him down along with Christian Paul. So it'll be second and short, second and 4 to go. Right now, best threat thus far here for Genoa. Here's the handoff again. This time, Antri going forward.
Not going to get it.
Well, he's going to be short of the first down. He's brought down at about the 23, so it'll be third and 3. Burrow brings him down.
Number 76, Caleb Wood.
So third and 3 to go here for the Comets.
We'll bring up third and 3.
Our front line's going to need to give Brunkhorst some protection here. I mean, they have been doing a good job here so far. Here's the handoff.
Oh,
what a hit. It's going to defend on the front forward progress. But it looks like he's got enough. He's standing on the 20, so this should be enough for a first.
You got to watch that one again, boy. I'll tell you. Watch this. Boom, boom, boom. That hurt.
Goodness.
That hurt.
I'm hurting just on the replay. That was, ooh. Nice job again from our camera crew here. We've got Rick and Dave. We appreciate the work they do. First and 10, just enough at the 20-yard line. Clock continues to run, 5:48 to go. Now we've got a whistle, and I believe timeout's going to be taken by Bill Fisher here with 5:46 to go in the first half. It remains 6-0 Oak Harbor. Here we go with a first and 10 from the 20. Over on the left side, that pass.
No good.
Incomplete. Well, had the right idea as he was looking for Denver Stewart, but did not go. Stewart was open, but I think that he may have, that ball, Bronckhorst may have held on to it just a split second too long.
Well, that, and you know, we talk about that all the time, that they're, it's timing. It's all about timing.
Let's see what happens here now. Over on the right side, this pass is complete.
Got out of bounds, too.
Great pass over there to Bryant, and Bryant is brought down. Pickup of about six, it looks like, so it'll be third down and four. Ball at the 14-yard line. So, again, an empty backfield. Got trips out to the left. Over here on the right, open. Here's the pass. That should be enough for the first down on the pass to Bryant. Bryant was brought down over there. Looks like Jackson Overmeyer. Uh-oh. It was enough for the first down, but...
You see a flag?
That's what I'm wondering. I saw the official over there talking, but... Nope, looks like it's going to be straight up first down. So it'll be first and goal from the 9-yard line here for the Comets. So I believe a timeout may have been taken.
Gotcha.
Oh, they've got an injury over there, that's why. So, but looks like things are cleared up. And we are ready to roll once again. Coming up here on the 5-minute mark in 10 seconds.
I'm going to bring you some DiStasio pizza, huh?
Hey. First things first. First and 10, trips out to the left again for the Comets. Bronckhorst rolls out to his left, looking downfield. Throws it, pulls it in, does he? Yes, touchdown. It was a delayed reaction, not only from everybody but the official, but it is a 9-yard touchdown pass. So it is a touchdown here for the Comets.
Let's look at this one again. I'll tell you, they really, really nice job there. Yeah, I'm going to hit that button again, Rick.
And there goes the baby.
We'll try that again here. There we go. Nice rollout, able to get to where he needed to get. Timing, and put it up in the air where he's only the only one that can get it.
Well, Agler goes up and tacks on the extra point. So with 4:52 to go here in the first half, the Comets with a nice drive. They put it together, and despite a long stoppage there for the injury timeout, they were able to put it together on a 9-yard touchdown pass, and they lead this one by a score of 7-6.
Genoa Bank is celebrating 120 years. Hi, I'm Marty Sutter, President and CEO of Genoa Bank. Since 1902, Genoa Bank has been caring for the financial needs of our neighbors. Our roots remain as we continue to serve our customers, our communities, and our families. Genoa Bank celebrates 120 years by reflecting on our past and, more importantly, focusing on our future. We will continue to make a positive difference in the lives of those who work, bank, and invest at Genoa Bank.
Pearl and Hayward back deep for the Rockets.
So Cameron Agler set to kick off here as the Comets with the lead right now over Oak Harbor 7-6. Hayward and Burrow back to receive here for the Rockets. It's a short kick grabbed at about the 10-yard line. So it's Burrow. It'll be dropped at about the 30-yard line. So that's where the Rockets will scrimmage first and 10. Denver Stewart in on the stop there for Genoa. And well, now it's Mike May and company's turn. See if they can put together a nice long drive to close out this first half.
Well, this is, once again, you know, there's not a lot of time been taken off the clock tonight, Mick, and I know we had the injury and everything, but, you know, a lot more passing than I really thought we would see tonight. And it's just amazing what they've been able to do for the passing here. And then you see these monstrously long runs. There you go.
So Hayward able to carry that ball for about 2 yards, and that was it. But Andrews Apila in on the stop there for the Comets. So they'll call it a 2 yard pickup, second and 8. And I got to tell you, this is, they're moving quickly here. The ball is handed off to Burrow again, and the Comets shut it down.
Yeah, not that time. Mick, I'll tell you what, honest to God, they know what to do and make sure everything gets done inside right there. And great stuff, though.
Well, that's why this rivalry has been so great for so many years. Oh. So third down, no gain on that play. So we'll see what Jackie Hayward and company have in mind.
Jackie.
Let's see, moves back into the gun. And you got to watch him because he can run. We saw that earlier.
Yep.
And now he's going to throw it over the middle. It falls incomplete. Yeah.
That wasn't an interception.
So it'll be fourth down here for the Rockets. Is clock will stop at 3:23 right now.
Fourth and what?
Fourth and, well, we'll call it 9.
Okay. It's a good number.
Short 9, long 8. It's right in between the mark.
My favorite golf club.
Of course. Inevitably. Inevitably.
Sure.
Kloon back to kick here for the Oak Harbor Rockets. Snap is good. Kick is good.
Kind of a short kick, though.
Yeah, it did. And it took a Genoa bounce back towards midfield. And that's where Genoa, with great field position here to start this drive, so it'll be first and 10 right at midfield. 3:14 to go here in this first half. So with only half the field to work with, Genoa with plenty of time to piece together a drive.
And, you know, honestly, they've been able to figure out some things here, and it's for the cross your fingers that it's waiting for that moment, and the guy is wide open in the middle of the pack, and we've seen it 2 or 3 times now.
Well, here we go, first and 10, right at midfield. Comet's been working pretty much with an empty backfield most of the night. Now it's going to be Brunkhorst rolling out to his right.
It's a broken play, broken play.
Yeah, it is. He's still able to keep moving.
Look at this.
Picks up the first down and more. Well, inside the 30, they'll spot him at the 28, it looks like. What a nice move, a 22-yard scamper on a broken play by Aiden Brunkhorst, and it'll be first down here for Genoa.
Well, you know, he's like, what do I do? What do I do? And then it just, the gates opened up, and it was wide open, and he was able to make something happen out of that. Nice job. Nice job.
Well, right out of the chute, Brunkhorst fires it over on the left side, and it looks like it's complete. good for a first down. Austin Teat with the reception.
And that'll get it. Nice catch, too.
Yeah, it is. So it's a first and 10 for Genoa. They'll spot the ball at the 17-yard line. Still plenty of time. There's the handoff as Antry goes up the gut.
Nothing there that time. Maybe two.
Picks up two. Be second and eight. Ridener in on the stop here for Oak Harbor.
Clock's running, and that's something that hasn't been happening too much tonight.
No, it hasn't. They need to eat up some clock here as they're inside the red zone. Second and eight. Run course, wheel route over here on the right side. Cutting back inside. Taking it to the house.
Folks, that's a touchdown.
17 yards. Touchdown. Entry for Genoa. Takes it home. Touchdown, Genoa Comets.
Let's watch that one again. This play just worked out so well with the way these guys were blocking. Just giving him some room and making good things happen, and he was able to go all the way to the end zone. Nice job.
Fantastic job there by the Comets, putting together a very quick, just a minute and 6 seconds on that drive. Agler puts up the extra point, and with 2:08 to go here in the first half, the Comets lead this one by a score, 14-6.
What can you expect from working with Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation? Our branch manager, Marty Binn, can help you navigate through the loan process with the service and speed you deserve. Contact Marty today to get pre-qualified. Make your home buying dreams a reality. Call 419-481-8696 to speak with Marty Binn today.
Hey, whatever works.
Sometimes let an athlete be an athlete.
Hayward Burrow back deep to receive the kick for the Rockets. Kicking off the Comets.
1-0 Mets.
Genoa's doing a nice job at getting the ball in the end zone quickly, Mick. And they've been able to capitalize on a couple of Oak Harbor, I don't want to say mistakes, but,
the short kick helped Genoa.
Yes, definitely.
It helped Genoa as far as they only had half the field to work with just over 3 minutes to go, and they were able to move quickly. As here's the kick, I think Burrow's going to pick that one up at the 20-yard line. Up over the 30, over the 35, out near the 40. So a good return here by the Rockets as Burrow takes it out there. Let's see where they spot that ball, but still decent field position as we are at 2:02 to go here in this first half. So still time here for the Rockets to try and strike quickly. So Lalonde is in at quarterback again. They've been switching back and forth between Michael Lalonde and Jackie Hayward. So Lalonde in on this one here, first and 10 from the, they're going to spot it at the 41. Fired over here on the left side. Burrow pulls it in, fights his way over the 45 to about the 48.
We'll see that one again, but, he had to wait. He had to wait for it, and he kind of dropped it and fumbled it a little bit and was able to turn it into an 8-yard gain.
Well, he juggled it is the easy way to say it.
Is that the word I want to use?
Yeah, there you go.
Sorry about that.
And this time he hauls it in easily as Burrow hauls it inside Genoa territory. They'll spot the ball at the Comet 44-yard line where it'll be first and 10 here for the Rockets as they continue to move quickly. Clock continues to stops, actually, because he went out of bounds with a 1:35 to go.
Well, too, you know what, Mick? This is a big boost if the Genoa defense can hold them.
Well, it remains to be seen. We'll see what the Rockets can do here. Lalonde, high snap, rolls out to his right. Throws one out there. It's complete to Nate Burrow. Did I say Nate? I meant Mr. Hayden Burrow. Haydenboro. That's what I was looking for, Haydenboro. It's only English, my mother tongue. What do I know?
I think it's Peyton, isn't it?
Hayden.
Hayden? Hayden. Oh, it's Peyton. Oh, you're right.
Well, regardless, it's second down.
Oh, everybody's coming by saying hi. Hey, J-Mo, glad you guys are back. Da, 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 da. I love it. Love it, love it, love it.
That's what it's about. So now, Alon throws to the right side. It's complete again.
That's this first time, down.
Yep, Ethan Stokes, the receiver that time, and they'll move the sticks as the clock is stopped with a 1:26. So effective clock management here by the Rockets as they're able to move this ball downfield. They started at their own, just outside their own 40, and they have been able to move the ball here pretty much at will. First and 10 at the Comet 33-yard line. Lalonde is going over the middle. He's got it. It is knocked away.
Somebody wanted that one, and I think it was on the defense.
Well, it was intended for Jackson Overmeyer. But it was tipped, and well,
oh,
second and 10. At the end of the day, that's all it is.
Yep, exactly.
Ball still at the 33 of Genoa. Clock is stopped with a 1:20.
Hey, we're going to be doing the Unsung Hero Award. Excuse me. Maybe if I can say that, from the Taylor Automotive Group. And I'm looking forward to doing that, Mick.
Lalonde putting some air on this one. And this time it is complete for a touchdown, 32 yards.
Yeah, we'll take you back for that one. That's, beautiful pass by Lalonde.
They're calling it a 32-yard pass play. And it, regardless, it's 6 more points here for the Rockets. But it was a beautiful pass.
Remember what we talked about where this could be a defensive struggle or it could be a lot of points. I think we're going to see a lot of points tonight, Mick.
Well, are they going to? I think they're going to go for 2 here to try and tie this ball game. So, Lalonde at quarterback. Man in motion. Lalonde's keeping it, rolling out to his right. Gets the ball off.
Nope.
And it does not go. So, a lot of pressure there on Lalonde. So, with a 1:15 to go here in the first half, Oak Harbor around the board again, but they still trailed Genoa by a score of 14-12.
Different problems require different solutions. Seagate Roofing and Foundation Services has been solving water problems for over 30 years. We have the expertise to provide you with the best solution. Seagate replaces foundations, straightens walls, lifts sinking foundations, and waterproofs basements. Get your free estimate before you make a decision because you deserve to have all the facts. We are the local experts.
244 LEAK Seagate.
Chris is putting himself off the hook.
For the Comets, number
he had a man on first. Not real pinpoint tonight.
And number 27, Ethan Antry, kicking off for the Rockets. His number 36.
But he's getting the job done.
Truck.
Rossford Port Clinton game 30-14 in the second quarter, Mick.
Well, here's a squib kick that's going to don't touch. Well, they're going to pick it up. I was thinking let it go out and you get good field position on the flag, but they pick it up. And Drummond returns it out to the – looks like they're going to spot it at the 34-yard line. Well, that was an impressive drive by Oak Harbor here. Just over a minute, and they went 60 yards.
Yeah. Boom, 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 eh?
Very quick. And then the officially stands as a 32-yard pass play. And, well, they're within striking distance now. They only trail by a deuce. trips out to the right here is the Comets. Will they try to do something here? Yes, they will. Brunkhorst fires it downfield deep, but a little too far.
Just a bit outside.
Teat was the intended receiver, but it was overthrown. So second and 10 from the 34. Still 65 seconds remaining in this first half.
Being a Rossford fan, kind of, too. You know, I love Genoa, Rossford, and all these teams. Every time I mention that, the other team scores. So I'm not going to anymore. I'll give you the score at the end of the game.
Brunkhorst pulls it down, goes up the middle, picks up the first down as he gets it out to about the 46, 47-yard line.
Mick, watch how he runs this thing. It's, once again, these timing patterns that he's doing and being able to take it right up the middle. Good job. Good job.
So they'll spot it at the 46. Clock continues to run. 50 seconds to go. Here's Brunkhorst. Fires it over on the left side. A little too hot. So that'll go incomplete. Second and 10.
Gotcha.
Stops the clock with 47 ticks remaining.
The longest 47 seconds is always that right at the end of the half, isn't it?
Yep.
Or right at the end of the game when you're up by one and they're driving.
Yeah, it's nerve-wracking. Here we go, Brunkhorst. Pulls it down again. He's going to try and get outside. It's going to be just shy of midfield, and that's it. So will they take a timeout?
Yeah.
And I believe they do.
Yep. Let's stay here.
Timeout with Genoa. Is we've got 34 seconds to go, just shy of midfield, but we're going to still call it the 50.
I got to tell you, I went over and saw my buddy Frank Comise over at Genoa Jewelers. You're going to laugh at me, but I got to get this story out there, okay?
Okay.
I found my class ring from Cardinal Stritch back in 1981, and my mom had it specially made for me. God love her. I didn't have a ring that looked like a regular ring. My ring was badass. It was a cool-looking ring. It was like something Spock would wear or William Shatner or something. Anyways, as you get older, those things don't fit. And I found it, and I went out to Frank, and I said, hey, do you think you can – he says, oh, yeah, we'll get that all done for you. So I'm really excited. I took it in, and Frank's going to – I guess he has to add some metal or – whatever that is. I don't know if it's gold. It's not gold. But so I'm going to get to wear my class ring again after 40 years. How's that?
My life is complete now.
Okay. I wanted that to be a complete.
Here's Brunkhorst. Throws it out on the right side. Incomplete pass. As he was looking for Drummond. So it makes it fourth down here with a half minute to go.
Gosh. What do you do, dude? I say you buckle down and you try to get the first down with running. Your quarterback can run that well, and he does it. Let it run.
Well, they're going to get into punt formation here. Huh. So Messenger. The snap is good. High kick. Grabbed at the 15. Fair catch. So Burrow will, with the fair catch, they'll spot it first and 10. Right around the, let's see, looks like they're going to mark it at about the 16. So, wow, these guys are moving this ball around like.
There had to have been a flag or something there. No?
Well, they're going to mark it at the 16-yard line. Yep. So, I think some of the confusion there was a couple of the officials were out near the 20, and it looked like that's where they were going to spot it.
Gotcha.
But nope. This is going to be a kneel now. So I think they're going to take a knee here with Jackie Hayward, and that's exactly what they're going to do. So they will call it a half. It's been an entertaining one, a very good first half of football between Oak Harbor and Genoa. But right now it's the home team leading it after the first half of football as they are up 14-12. This is the Toledo Sports Network High School Football Game of the Week. Stick around. We'll be back with more after this.
Pro Golf Fairways at Cameo Pizza and Resets in Rossford and Monroe Street right next to Nick and Jimmy, with top-of-the-line golf simulators, duckpin bowling, and the best food for your night out. We've got you covered. It's Pro Golf Fairways with all the greatest golf courses in the area. Why not come out and hit a few with us at Pro Golf Fairways at Cameo Pizza and Resets in Rossford and Monroe Street next to Nick and Jimmy. Graymont in Genoa, producers of dolomite, lime, and hydrate, serving the community for over 90 years. The plant currently has 60 employees. The safety and development of these employees is a focus for your plant. Over 80% of our employees currently live within 11 miles of the plant. Graymont. For more information about this company, you can check us out on the web at www.graymont.com.
On the ground. Those are like the quickest games we ever do as an Eastwood game. You notice that?
Just a coincidence, I'm sure.
Uh-huh.
Anyhow, the ball is being returned here for the Rockets, as I believe. Well, it'll be first and 10 here.
Right. You know, I just wanted to say something to Dave if he's listening to us here now on camera. That's a perfect shot right there, Dave. Beautiful shot.
So it's first and 10 here for the Rockets. They'll have the ball at their own 25-yard line to start things off. So it'll be Lalonde at quarterback here. He's been out there most of the time here for Oak Harbor, splitting some time between him and Jackie Hayward. In the shotgun. Lalonde's going to keep it as they go over the right side, pushing forward. Good run there. Pickup of about 7, it looks like. And right now the Rockets are going to the hurry up. This is an interesting little wrinkle. Here over on the left side now. The pass is complete, but for a loss. Pass was intended there for Jackson Overmeyer, and he was shut down immediately by Robert Messenger. And, well, loss of a couple. So that'll make it 3rd down and 5.
It should be more than that, shouldn't it?
No, they lost a couple yards, so it was at the 32. So it was back at the 30, and they need to get to the 35 to move the sticks.
Hey, you're the one who passed math, not me.
Never mind. Fingers and toes, my friend, fingers and toes. Here you go, Lalonde now. He's going to get flushed out of the pocket. He's going to run with it. He's got room. Gets outside, and he's going to.
You got it.
Yep, he picks up the first down and more.
He definitely got it. It was that last effort.
Yep, and he's going to be brought down around, I believe, the 38, it looks like. Knight brought him down here for Genoa, but not before a first down here for Oak Harbor.
Nice move here, and getting to the outside and then fighting it, spinning it, and getting that first down.
First and 10 here for Oak Harbor. Burrow goes up the gut. He'll get to about the 40, and that's it. So we'll give him a couple of yards. Well, let's see where they they're spotting it at the 39, so just a pickup of 1. So when the sun sets, you know that my eyesight does as well. So anyway, it's 2nd down and 9. Now here's Lalonde, flushed out on the right side. He's fighting for it, but he's not going to make it back to the line of scrimmage as he is going to be sacked.
Yeah, there's got a player down right now. He just got up.
So right now they're crediting Drew Posey with the sack. And they're going to spot the ball at the 34, so it's a 5-yard loss.
Hmm. Well, take that back. It is a 6-yard loss. My apologies. So much for my math, right?
Yeah, you know, Mick, you Central Catholic guys, I'll tell you. You knew that was coming, didn't
you? Yeah, that's true. Here we go. Third down. Alon looking downfield.
Oh,
that pass for Burrow.
He had a flag down, too.
It's incomplete, and the whistle went. Burrow kept playing, but got flags on the play, and Burrow not happy, but the whistle sounded before he picked up that ball.
I'm looking. Yeah, there's a hold in there.
So holding will be called against. Well, will they call it or will they decline it? Because it should be
fourth and a bunch. They're going back.
They're
going
to go back. So.
No, now they're going forward. All right, come on. So.
Unless they're declining. Yep, they're declining it. So gotcha. That's why. I think they started moving it back, but then they didn't realize that Genoa declined it. So now that they've got that figured out.
Thank you. Receive the punt. The Comets, number 24.
It'd be fourth and a lot.
Yeah, they wouldn't have needed to get out to the 48-yard line. So.
3-2.
Kloon here. Low snap. Gets it together. Gets the kickoff and a good one. This one's going to take an Oak Harbor bounce. They'll down it at the Genoa 25-yard line. And that's where Genoa will open this second half at first and 10.
And this is that time where they had so much momentum going into the end of that second quarter. This is where they got to, if Genoa's got that momentum to make this thing rock.
Well, we'll see what happens here. Is so far, Aiden Brunkhorst has been pretty steady. As long as that's the thing you want with Genoa, especially when you've got, you know, a first-year head coach. Even though Bill Fisher has a ton of experience as an assistant, as the head man, this is his first year. So we'll see what happens here. Empty backfield. Brunkhorst rolling out to his left. He's going to pull it down.
Yeah, smart move. Smart move.
Get some positive yardage there. It looks like he'll get one, maybe it's about it, one. So second and 9. Clock continues to run under 8:45 remaining.
Something we haven't said very much tonight, the clock continues to run, right?
This is true. However, after last week, everything was just flying right along.
Gosh.
But this week it's more conventional, traditional football game. Brunkhorst keeping the ball as he goes over the left side. He gets it out to around the 31, maybe 32-yard line. We'll see where they spot it. It looks like the 32.
So when you say conventional, Mick, it means I'm going to edit for 3 hours, right? Is that what
Yeah, unfortunately so, Mr. Jameson, I got to tell you.
I got 1 hour and 58 minutes to do the game. So.
Yeah, well, and you're going to do some more editing here because we have an injury timeout here. Yeah. There's an injured Rocket on the field. So we'll take a timeout. 8:17 left to go here in the third quarter. It remains 14-12 Genoa.
Skyworks is a family-owned and operated business specializing in new and used aerial work platforms, sales, rentals, and service. In addition to aerial lifts, we offer material handling equipment, construction equipment, sales featuring new and used telehandlers, excavators, skid steers, scissor lifts, boom lifts, and forklifts, and much more. Contact Skyworks today, 419-662-8630. Proud sponsor of high school sports in the area.
Third and 4 here for the Comets as they will scrimmage from their own 31-yard line. Over here on the right side, the pass.
I don't think he got there.
Nope, I don't think so either. If he did, they're giving him a nice spot.
Wow, they are giving him a nice
spot. That's a generous spot.
They're moving them.
It's a third. They're marking it at the 36, and they're going to call it a first down. Wow.
That's good. Genoa Comet fan, you're.
Yeah, if you're a Genoa Comet fan, that's great. Uh-huh. You know, it's a great spot. If you're an Oak Harbor fan, not so much. First and 10, Genoa. Their own 36, Brunkhorst is going to keep it. Goes on the right side. He's fighting his way over the 40 to about the 43.
Hey, Nichols, remember what I was talking about with the waiting for things to happen? I'm going to show you this one again. It's just incredible what just waiting, patience, and boom, then that hole opens up and he's able to get to where he needs to get. Nice job.
Burrow stopped that one, and he was slow to get up, but then he popped up and he's trying to, whatever, if he got hurt, he's just trying to shake it off. But I think his coach, Mike May, said he's having him come off the field.
Hey, Bomber says hi. He says the game looks great. He says the announcers, he could do better, but you know how Bomber is.
Well, he could. That's the sad part.
You're
right. That's the sad part. He could do better than either of us.
I know.
Brunkhorst now keeps that one driving over off the left side. It's going to be short of the first down. He'll get it out to about the 44-yard line. Yeah, bye, Bomber. We're talking about our former colleague and dear friend still, Mr. Mike Ballman, of course, watching the game down in Nashville.
He's loving it.
Oh, that's a good thing. So.
See, I think he's watching it and saying, wow, this really looks good. Now he wants to come back and do games. I get it.
We'd welcome him back with open arms.
In a heartbeat. Well, you know, because you and I are not, you know, physically handsome where Mike is, so it works out good.
We've got faces for radio.
That's it.
Here we go now. 2 yards needed. And 1 yard, if that gained, and that's about it. That one, I don't even think he got to the 45. Antry was just shut down. Great job there by the Oak Harbor defense. Wilson and Alon in on the stop there for Oak Harbor. And here we go. Fourth and 2 from the 44. They need the 46.
Take it right up the gut.
Well, he's dropping back.
Yeah, you're going to throw it.
High snap.
Oh.
Still a good kick. Well, I thought it was, but until I seen the angle of it, and then not so much. They're going to spot the ball at the 20. Well, he's moving up. So it'll be all the way up to the 35. Wow. So that was a bad pun, unfortunately, for Genoa, as they'll spot that ball at the Oak Harbor 35, where the Rockets will scrimmage first and 10.
Hey, we haven't gotten much word out about Mr. Scott Winkowski. I know he comes and does our radio show. Tomorrow we're going to be over at Heather Downs doing our radio show. Scott, you never know. Scott pops in. He's kind of like Dean Martin coming in to, like, you know, the Johnny Carson show. He just kind of shows up, and I love it. I love it when he does that. And great attorney.
There's the dish off to Burrow on the right side. Fighting through. He's going to pick up a first down.
Quick first down.
Yep, that's what you need if you're Oak Harbor. And, well, they're going to – let's see where they spot that ball. They'll spot it at the 46-yard line, first and 10, Oak Harbor.
Yeah, nice movement here. This kid's got some legs on him, man. I'll tell you what, he can spin, and he's really got good balance.
So, first and 10 here for the Rockets, 5:23 to go and counting. Here's the snap. Lalonde's going to air it deep. A little too far. Ooh. Close.
He had him, too.
He did. He just a little bit too far for Burrow, as Burrow was there, but he dove for it and couldn't come up with it. So.
We got a flag on
here. Oh, we got a flag here. I think it's illegal person downfield. Oh, wait. Take it back. We got contact, illegal head contact. So that's going to be against Genoa. So Oak Harbor will still be able to pick up the first down, as that ball will be moved into
Genoa territory as they'll spot that ball at, I believe, the, let's see, the 39, it looks like.
Is that what it?
Here's Lalon over on the left side. Burrow on the left side this time with the reception.
Ooh.
He'll get it. He'll fight to about the 32-yard line, maybe 31. Let's see where they spot that ball. It'll be short of the first down. He needs to get to the 29.
Watch this. Boy, I'll tell you. One, two.
Well, here we go.
Four.
Second down and short here for the Rockets. Right now, Lalon just looking to the sideline. Moves back into the shotgun. Fires a dart over to Burrow on the left side, complete for a first down. Inside the 25-yard line to about the 23, and that's where the Rockets will scrimmage from after they move the chains.
Yeah, that's been the Achilles heel, it seems, for Genoa, as these guys have been able to just eat that little bit out right there and get that 6 or 8 yards, and that's all they need.
First and 10 here for Old Carver. 4:10 to go. Here's the snap. Lalon will roll out to his right. Dishes it off to Burrow. Burrow is...
Did he get it?
Oh, wait, take that back. That was Ethan Stokes. Stokes with the reception, and now they go back to the hurry up, and that's been successful here on this drive for Old Carver. Pickup of 7, second and 3.
Yeah, we were talking a little bit about Ethan, and he's just a sophomore. He's an incredible basketball player and a great kid. But they're using that 6'5", 6'6", you know, body and making some good things happen.
Lalon's going to fire it out here on the left side, nearly intercepted. So I think it was Stokes who was the intended receiver, but regardless – Messenger almost had a gift. That'll stop the clock. 3:22 to go. And that'll make it third down. 3 to go. The ball just outside the 16-yard line.
Taylor Automotive Group's helping us out with the unsung hero of the game. And... Mickey, starting to make some numbers yet?
Yeah, I'm starting to look and notice some things. Timeout going to be taken, though, here by Old Carver. 3:22 to go. Old Carver right now trailing by 2, but they're knocking on the door. We'd like to see.
It's not too early to start thinking about updating your boat or motorcycle with a new sound system. Get custom marine sound system installations for just about anything that floats. And enjoy the open road with motorcycle head unit and sound system upgrades from TAS. Fast, expert installation from the area's leader in connected mobile technology.
TAS Electronics. You know, TAS Electronics.
What inning are they in?
Oh, this is football, Mick. Smart butt J-Mo.
Third and 3 here for the Rockets. 16-yard line. Here's the snap. Juan's going to hand it off, and it's going to be close. But
I don't think he got it, Nick.
Let's see where they spot that ball. I think he's going to be about a yard short. It looks like they're going to spot it at the 14. Andrew Zapila with the stop.
At this point, you got to go for it, though. Got to go for it.
Well, they've got a decent kicker, but he's also a freshman.
He's a soccer player that could put it through, but they're going to go for it. Fourth down and a yard to go. They go up the gut.
Up.
False start here against Oak Harbor.
I don't know if we got that, but I'm going to check right now. Genoa fans are loving it. Oh, we were too late on the click.
So it is, goes from 4th and 1 to 4th and 6.
Gosh, what a great night for football.
Yep, it's absolutely beautiful out here. So I think they're still going to go for it. So
I think you got to.
It is 4th and 6. They need to get to, well, let's see what they do here. Lalonde holds it, goes up the gut.
He knew he was going.
Runs for it, gets the first down and more.
Lalonde with the scramble.
Well.
Picks up enough yardage for Rocket. First down.
So he was stopped by Jake Knight.
Brings up first and goal.
So it's going to be first and goal here for Oak Harbor on a scrappy run there by Lalonde.
Well, that's what you got to do, Mick. And you saw it. You saw what they were able to accomplish with just trying to push the ball. And that's another one of them delayed plays, you know. And, gosh, they've been misdirection doing it all night.
First and goal from the 7. Here now rolling out to his left. Lalonde, he's going to keep it.
Ooh.
Gets hit.
Big time.
Lalonde, the ball carrier, stop made by number 3.
He was drilled there by Braden Bryant. So it'll be 2nd and goal.
Yeah, Genoa player down.
Yep. That stops the clock with an injury timeout. 90 seconds left here in the 3rd quarter. But an injury timeout on the field with Oak Harbor threatening to score. Well, looks like we're ready to roll here now. It's 2nd and goal from the 1. Lalonde hands it up the gut.
Right
through. And they get it right through. It's a touchdown, Oak Harbor Rockets.
Yeah, you can watch him just blow through that hole. Real, real nice job right there.
Yep. So, Rockets now with the lead, and they're most likely going to go for 2 here. Well, here we go. Rockets going for 2. Here's the handoff to Burrow. Burrow, I don't think.
No way.
Nope, didn't get through. So the 2-point conversion is no good. 1:21 left to go here in the 3rd quarter, and a 1-yard plunge by the Rockets give them the lead as they are up over Genoa 18-14.
Genoa Bank is celebrating 120 years. Hi, I'm Marty Sutter, President and CEO of Genoa Bank. Since 1902, Genoa Bank has been caring for the financial needs of our neighbors. Our roots remain as we continue to serve our customers, our communities, and our families. Genoa Bank celebrates 120 years by reflecting on our past and, more importantly, focusing on our future. We will continue to make a positive difference in the lives of those who work, bank, and invest at Genoa Bank.
Not a bad thing at all.
No, I can live with it.
Well, here we go. Trying to keep it away. Going to be picked up here by Antry. Antry's going to go up over the 15. He's not going to make it to the 20. So, no spot the ball at the 15. That's where Genoa will scrimmage. 1st and 10, 1:16 left to go here in the 3rd.
Got to say thanks to the great folks over at Graymont for helping us out like they always do in Genoa games. We appreciate them. More than you can imagine.
Always. And don't forget, if you want to advertise here on the Toledo Sports Network, be sure to give my partner a call, 514-1302, during normal business hours, of course.
Yeah, he didn't call me anything that long.
First and 10. Here's the pass play over to Antry. Antry didn't get much, but at least they get a positive yard out of it. So it'll be well, let's see. They're going to give them two? Well, let's see. We got a flag on the play, so.
Remember that one night where we must have had 40 flags in one game?
Yeah, I honestly thought that day they changed the turf color from green to yellow.
Yeah, all I know is I'll sit down in front of the old computers tomorrow and turn this into an hour and 58-minute game. It's going to be almost 3.5, almost 4 hours here by the time we get everything done because we're way after 9 o'clock now. So.
But that's what makes it interesting and that's what makes it fun.
You know, I just love it. I love the game, and except sometimes it just, you know, when the refs do their thing, you know, those darn tooting refs.
Well, it looks like there was some offsetting and sportsmanlike conduct penalties, one on each side, so they offset, so it'll remain. They'll call it second and 6. That ball will be at the 19-yard line.
Ooh.
And this time around.
That's a first down, my friend.
That's going to be pretty close. So, on course, the keeper. And, yeah, I think you're right. It's going to be they're going to move the sticks.
Got in there and did what he needed to do.
Under a minute to go here in the third quarter.
Mets are up 4-3.
So, about one more play to run here in the third quarter before they change ends. Off the snap, Brunkhorst is going to keep it. And this time, well, not much in the way of real estate acquisition there. And that should be the final play of the third quarter. As they'll spot the ball at the, looks like the 30. Oh, check that, 28. Clock will wind down to 0, and we've got 3 in the books here in Genoa. Oak Harbor on a 1-yard touchdown plunge take the lead, and they lead this one right now as we head into the final quarter, 18-14.
It's time for the end of the third quarter. Drawing.
Blackberry Corner on the corner of 579 and Elliston Road is a proud sponsor of Genoa football and has the best burgers, chicken, and pizza. You know the pizza. Everyone knows the pizza. Blackberry Corner also has charbroiled pork ribs and Jim's famous chicken dinners. Whether it's appetizers, pizza, or a full dinner, the great folks at Blackberry Corner can help fill you up and save you money. Stop out to Blackberry Corners on the corner of State Route 579 and Elliston Road for a meal or just a snack.
Quarter number 4 underway. First play. Brunkhorst going to air it out on the right side to start this last stanza. Goes incomplete. Drummond the intended target, but that one didn't go as planned. So that'll make it 3rd and 9.
I'm missing the running game here, Mick.
Well, there's a couple things you're missing here. I mean, Jackie Hayward, we have not heard word one from him on the offensive side of the ball.
Right.
Now, Lalonde, to his credit, has been playing pretty decent at quarterback here for Oak Harbor. Here's Brunkhorst. He's going to air it out over here. Pass is complete. It's going to depend on where they spot that. Messenger with the reception. Looks like they're going to spot it at the 39. And depending on the spot, it should be enough for a first down. I think I said Messenger was actually Teat. So Austin picking up that pass.
They gave it to him?
Yep. And they're giving him a first down.
Bomber keeps texting me, man. I think he wants to come back. I think he does.
Here's the snap.
I'm going to take it.
Brunkhorst takes it up the gut.
Nice carry. Nice carry.
He'll take it for about 5 yards out to the 44-yard line.
Well, he was just able to get it in there and do some Wango Tango. Wango Tango, that's it, sorry.
Close enough.
Don't you just want to take me in a back room and slap me one of these days?
Never mind.
Wouldn't be the first time.
Yeah, it's true. The line for that would be long but distinguished. Rolling out now is Brunkhorst. Fires it over, and it's complete into Oak Harbor territory.
They're giving it to him, yep.
Looks like about the 44-yard line maybe of Oak Harbor. Enough for a first down.
It's complete. Number three.
Looks like Brian. Let's see that one again here. Got it in there. Boom. Boy, I can't believe how you held on to that ball.
Yeah, good coverage here by Oak Harbor. Just a better play by Bryant. So first and 10 for the Comets at the Oak Harbor 44-yard line. And it's toss over here on the left side. Antry gets it inside the 40 to about the 35. So it'll be about a yard short of the first down. Brought down by Michael Lalonde.
A second and one.
Yep. So here we go. It's an opportunity to take a shot downfield if you're Genoa, but they're going to just pull it down as Brunkhorst will run it. Moves the sticks, breaks free, gets outside, brought down inside the 20-yard line.
I like it.
Big time play there by Brunkhorst. And Genoa knocking on the door again.
Told you this is going to be a high-scoring game, Mick.
Well, it's going to go back and forth here.
Either way, I mean, both of these teams are playing real well.
That they are. So it's going to be first and 10 from the 16. So Brunkhorst again, he's just working it. He's, you know, if it isn't broke, don't fix it.
I agree. Totally agree.
Good mix here on the play calling from Bill Fisher, but you know Mike Vickers has also got a hand in this as well as the OC. So second down and 7. The ball at the 13-yard line as we're at 9:15 to go here in the ball game. Brunkhorst going to air it over here on the left side.
Yeah.
Pass is complete.
Never saw it, Mick. We had a bad camera angle on that one.
Robert Messenger hauls it in for a touchdown. Touchdown, Genoa Comets. Beautiful 13-yard pass play from Brunkhorst over to Robert Messenger. And Genoa has taken the lead back once again. My goodness. Well, here we go with the point after. Agler puts it up, and it is good. So with 9:04 left to go here in the fourth quarter, the Comets have come back to take the lead once again, 21-18.
I'm very impressed with it so far.
Yeah, we've always been used to Genoa being a running team, and the fact that they've been able to change things up here, very impressive. This will be grabbed here by Burrow at the 15-yard line, up over the 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. Forced out of bounds and outside the 40-yard line. Otherwise, he'd still be running.
I think he needed 2 inches, right?
Hagler was the kicker, is the guy that forced him out at the 42. So.
Stepped out at the 42, it looks like.
27-yard return for Mr. Burrow. First and 10, Oak Harbor
See if they have an answer. We'll see what Lalonde does here for the Rockets. Here's that swing pass outside to Burrow. Burrow this time, though, can't turn it upfield as the Comets were wise to this one.
Boy, you saw some great defense right there. And it's one of those things, if you just know when it's going to happen, well, there you go. Genoa, it was right place, right time, and did the things they needed to do to make sure he did not get any yardage.
Yep, a loss, in fact.
Hell, I thought it was all the way back here to 35.
They're going to spot the ball at the 39, so a loss of three. Second and 13. Lalonde forced out of the pocket. He's going to try and run it himself. He'll get back near the original line of scrimmage, but that's about it.
Stop made by number 52.
As he was brought down by Donnie Tucholsky, so that'll make it third and long. So third and 10.
Brings up third and 10.
Still plenty of time here for Oak Harbor, 7:45. In the shotgun.
Way too close, Dave. Way too close.
Now here we go. Over on the left side for the home run ball. And it's caught. Nope, they're calling it incomplete.
Yeah.
They're saying he was out of bounds.
Incomplete.
Mike May is not a happy man at the moment. Oh, my goodness. That one.
That could be a game changer right there, Mick.
Yep, because it goes from, you know, knocking on the door to fourth and 10.
He is not happy.
So it's going to be a punting situation instead here for Oak Harbor.
And they have to.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, all they can do is hope that they can go three and out for Genoa right now, so they'll get the ball back with around, you know, 3-4 minutes left and be able to do some justice there. But, you know, they're going to have to.
Well, here we go. Grab Messenger, picks it up at the 22. He'll get it out to around the 25, 26. Before he is brought down, that says a lot. Here we go. Brunkhorst keeps it. He's going to get outside.
There you go.
And now he's got some yardage and a first down. Still
nice
moving.
Job.
Forced out of bounds, but not before. An impressive run there by Aiden Brunkhorst getting outside, picking up the first down as he's forced out at approximately the 43-yard line.
Well, watch him on this because – you know, it's that delayed reaction and waiting for things to happen. Great blocking by the running backs and making things happen there. And, hey, guess what? First down, you get to hold the ball some more. And that's, at this point, what you want to do. You want to get the clock rolling and just keep getting the first downs. Way too close, Dave. Way too close.
First and 10 here at the 43. Antry now. Goes up the gut on the left side.
Now you just keep it on the ground. If you can do that and get 6 yards out of that carry, that's perfect.
So it'll be second and four from the Genoa 49-yard line. And the clock right now continues to run. Under 6:50 to go.
Use every ounce of this clock, every ounce that you can.
We call those seconds.
Is that what we do?
Yeah. The ounces, that's for after the game. I'll explain that to you later. Anyhow.
Oh, yeah. Eighth grade does.
This time around, not so much. Antry is dropped at around the line of scrimmage. Well, they'll give him a yard, so midfield. So a nice play there by the Rockets defense as Brayden Schultz was able to slam the door on him. So, they're taking Drew Posey out.
Got him on the stretcher.
Oh, they got him on the stretcher. Oh, boy. Hopefully that's just
worse than it looks. Let's hope for that, or not as bad as it looks. Let's put it that way. As that pass is complete over into around the 44-yard line, it looks like, for Messenger.
Nice.
That's a herder.
Ooh.
I don't know, Mick. I don't know. It looks like he bobbled that. But we don't have instant replay here. So, well, we do, but, you know. And then they'll start the clock.
Fire up that clock, Bobby.
So, at the 44, it is first and 10. Man in motion here now, Brunkhorst. Brunkhorst bounces outside, gets over inside the 35. Was he able to stay in bounds? Well, there, no, doesn't look like.
Nice play, though.
Should have enough for a first down. So, Garrett Lindsay on the stop, but not before Brunkhorst breaks off a 10-yard run. Under 5.5. Kind of going back and forth between watching the game and watching Drew Posey over here at the Genoa bench. Tell you what, the first responders have had a busy night tonight. Here's the handoff. Is going up his entry. He'll take it through the line and pick up a couple yards. So Reidner in on the stop. Reidner's had a pretty solid game on defense here for Oak Harbor. Well, we'll see what happens here now.
He's got 14 tackles, 58.
Yep. Reidner, I've just been informed, he's got 14 tackles. So he's had a busy
night.
Busy night.
Yeah, way too close, Dave.
Here on the left side, Brunkhorst. Well, let's make that 15 tackles for Reidner, as he may end up being our unsung hero here.
About third and six.
A little less than that.
Brings up third five.
Well, here we go. Trips out to the right side. Twins to the left. Empty backfield here as Brunkhorst will take the snap. Throws it over the left side, but it goes incomplete. Well, here we go. Fourth down. We'll get into the Taylor Automotive Unsung Hero of the Game here in just a moment. But first, Brunkhorst throws it over the middle. Oh, my goodness. Are you kidding me?
Wow. That ball hung in the air for 20 seconds.
Oh, my goodness. Mason Drummond hauls that puppy in, and unbelievable. That could swing things for me now as who the unsung hero is.
Wow.
That was incredible. That was incredible. First down here for the Comets. First and goal, I should say, at the 9. So, most importantly for Genoa, the clock continues to run.
Amen. Yeah, if you're a Genoa fan right now, you want to now keep it on the ground. Yep, there you go.
So there's Antry going on the right side. Unsung hero of the game.
Taylor Automotive.
Taylor Automotive, I'm sorry. Because the Hyundai brand as well. Yes, here we go. On the handoff is Robert Messenger. He's driving, but he's going to be short. Doesn't quite get there, but. And let's see how we finish up here for Genoa. 3:02 on the clock.
Somebody needs to pick up three.
Third and goal from the 3. On
that's
the left
touchdown.
Side. Touchdown, Genoa Comets.
That's game, folks.
That is Robert Messenger with a 3-yard touchdown run.
Let's watch that again, because I'll tell you what. Perfect blocking again, just making it happen. I'll tell you what, for Genoa, you got to talk about that offensive line tonight, Mick. gosh, they've done such a tremendous job.
Yeah, you can't ask for more than that. You know, the guys up front, as we like to call them, the buffet boys, they have been working hard because, well, the lines for both, we talked in the open at the outset of this ball game, Mike, you and I both talked about the fact that what happened in the trenches was probably going to be the deciding factor
certainly
in this ball game, and it's come to fruition, as that is exactly what has happened for both teams, really, because Oak Harbor has been able to put – they've been a thorn in the side of Genoa here tonight. They didn't let them run away with it easily. But to credit the Comets, they've had guys out there that have been really working hard. You know, I mean, obviously, you know, you look at guys like Zapila, Jennifer – trying to think of who else off the top. Geddes, just a lot of these guys are working really hard to.
Hayward Burrow back to receive the kick.
And also the other thing too, you got that I've just been handed a note. Genoa now getting ready on this kickoff for their 70th play of the game. Well, they've had 69 offensive plays. Oak Harbor's had 40.
Oh, well, there you go.
That's a big difference. Here's the short kick. Now they're going to try a little razzle-dazzle. Getting outside. Oh, great last-moment shoestring tackle. I think that saved a touchdown.
Yeah, they misdirected that one. And yeah, like
Hayward, who we haven't heard from since the first quarter, really. And Hayward's hurt. He's hobbling. And you don't want to see that as an Oak Harbor fan.
Oh.
Or any fan, actually. He is going off the field, and he's going off under his own power, but he is hobbling.
A little bit, yeah. Don't forget, we'll have Rossford Oak Harbor next week on the Toledo Sports Network, and we do them live. We don't charge you anything. You know, we've got our PayPal thing there. If you want to throw us $5, we appreciate it. It always helps. So, oh, long out.
There you go.
And he
that
got
pass
it.
Is complete, and that's going to go for a touchdown. Are you kidding me? 60-yard pass.
Wow.
Burrow hauls it in for 60 yards and an Oak Harbor touchdown.
Boom, all of a sudden, boom.
Things just got a whole lot more interesting.
Wow.
With 2:40 left to go. My goodness.
Do you go for two here, Mick?
No, you go for one because you're only down three. If you miss it on the, they
well,
haven't.
That's my point. You know,
they haven't been able to do anything with the 2-point conversion tonight. So you might as well get your one and then go for the tie
that's
if
true.
You have to.
That's true. And you got a good kicker. You say he's a freshman, though.
Yep, he's a soccer player. The kid they got off the soccer team. Krupp now puts it up and puts it through. So 2:40 on the clock, and it's 28-25.
Yeah, I'm going to have to cut all this off. 42 minutes I have to cut, Mick.
Good night.
No.
Well, most of that's from the injury, isn't it, the first injury?
We'll see. We'll see.
That by itself was like 15 minutes.
Yeah, 9 minutes. Thank you for all the good comments, folks. I appreciate it. Yeah, that's cool. Looking forward to going to Oak Harbor next week, though. That'll be a lot of fun.
Well, we've been there before, and they've always been nothing but gracious to us.
Oh, yeah.
Just like the folks here at Genoa, they've been wonderful here. No complaints. And the onside kick attempt, it's bounced, and it's grabbed by Brunkhorst was out there, and he grabs that one for Genoa.
Nick, how many timeouts does Oak Harbor have left?
I think they have one. No, take it back. None.
None. Gotcha.
So 6 seconds come off the clock, 2:34 remaining. So now.
You have first down, and basically it's yours, it, right?
Mm-hmm. So we'll see what happens, because you know Oak Harbor, is going to be reaching in there, trying to strip the ball.
Sure.
All those little things that.
Well, they're a very talented team, and you know, you're seeing some very good early season football here.
Here's the handoff to Messenger. Messenger fighting his way through near midfield. And like picks up 6 yards into Oak Harbor territory at the 49, where Thompson with the stop, but still second and manageable here for Genoa, and Oak Harbor can't stop the clock.
Right.
So we come up on 2 minutes remaining. Comets now looking to pick up a first down so they can call the best play there is in all of football. Victory formation. Here's the handoff. Bryant picks up the first down as he gets it inside the 45 to the 43. And, well, that should do it. So the clock will start. Now with a 140 to go, and well, three victory formation plays. So Brunkhorst will go under center.
Oh yeah, this thing's over.
As he's just taking his time now, getting that clock to wind down, and now they're going to take the knee. And I tell you what, it was a very entertaining ball game here, Mike, and it's about what we expected. You know, anytime you get a game like this, a rivalry game, and of course, after come next year, it will be an in-conference rivalry game.
Yeah, it's going to be some mean stuff next year, I can tell you that. Looking forward to it.
Yeah, when Oak Harbor comes in, Maumee comes in. Of course, you got to say goodbye to Elmwood. You've got to say goodbye to Woodmore, but it's still going to be the NBC, and it'll be
definitely
very good football. There's another knee taken there by Brunkhorst, and that's going to do it as the Genoa Comets come back to and hold on to defeat the Oak Harbor Rockets by a score of 28-25. So Genoa goes to 1-1, and then Oak Harbor will fall to 1-1.
Wait, I see a
they're calling a delay a game penalty here on Genoa. So all the coaches for Oak Harbor are on the field ready to line up and go shake hands. I think they even if they decline, they still got to run a play. Oh, they declined it, so they're going to just have them run it. That was crazy. But it's
wrap
still
it up, Mick.
The
We're
game
so
is
far.
Yep, the game is over, so both teams now at 1-1. We'll talk to you next week when Rossford pays a visit to Oak Harbor, and we'll have the call there for you on the Toledo Sports Network High School Football Game of the Week. For Dave and Rick on cameras, we thank them. For my partner, Mike Jamison, I'm Mick Gonzalez saying so long, everybody, from Genoa, where your final once again, the Genoa Comets 28 and the Oak Harbor Rockets 25. You've been watching high school football. This is the Toledo Sports Network.